get a shot of protection, the swine flu shot.
I was talking with this dude because he worked in a hospital and he knew very well what the virus is and everything. And I asked him, how come I'm not getting it? Can you tell me how long is the time from when you get it to when you first see some symptoms? He told me it's about a week. I told him, how come I'm not getting it? Then he thought about it and it said, but it depends on the person. Guys, this guy, I told him, just directly, I told him, will you guys stop killing people just because they give you money? He just smiled. When he left, he didn't salute me. He just left as a very arrogant, you know, didn't salute me. Just like a little children, you know. The problem is this, guys. These experts, guys, are hired because they are little soldiers, cold as fuck. And we are in the hands of these fools, guys. We might think that we are dealing with experts, but these people are sick, guys. Are sick and just little children, you know? These are the people in power in these places, guys. These people are sick and gonna come without any heart, you know, cold as fuck as they are. And they're gonna kill us all, guys.
We gotta pay attention to stories like this coming off the corporate media. So here's one. South Africa makes it illegal to spread false information about the coronavirus. It's very troubling how this is all rolling out. I had to take down all my coronavirus videos because of what YouTube had announced a few days ago when they said that because of the coronavirus, all their employees are staying home and therefore they're using artificial intelligence programs and there's going to be a lot more videos than normal being taken down. And I think we're seeing now this emanate. Also, there's been shutdowns of internet. Several states yesterday had shutdowns, some of them lasting hours and hours. We saw this play out last year in California, where they had these shutdowns of the internet. I believe that they're prepping for something like this, that they're going to amp up this whole situation and then cut the plug sort of thing, and then we're all going to be, you know, because we've become so used to what's going on with the internet and instant communication and all that, then all of a sudden, you know, and they've set it up over the past decade or so, getting everybody on smartphones and, you know, away from traditional sort of methods of communication. So it could be a perilous situation for a lot of people if they pull the plug on the internet, which is something I anticipate. And it's something that, of course, they said with Event 201 that would be a high probability that they were going to shut down the internet. So I tried to show that in my infodemic video, how serious this situation is. And so you see stories like this one here. South Africa makes it illegal to spread false information about coronavirus. And now they're saying here, this is off CNN, in South Africa, spreading false information about the coronavirus is now a crime punishable by up to 6 months in prison, a fine, or both. The move is one of several new measures announced by the government late Wednesday in an effort to halt the spread of the virus and curb misleading rumors on social media. Other measures include legally enforcing testing, treatment, and quarantine or isolation of suspected cases. Earlier this week, a family in the Gauteng province refused to be isolated after being tested positive and had to be brought in by police and a court order. Visits to prisons have been suspended, and gatherings of more than 100 people and all that. So it's always a little bit here, a little bit there. What you see happen there, all of a sudden next week it's here. So you see China, quarantines, lockdown, Spain. You know, a couple weeks later it's Italy, then it's Spain, then it's California. You see all the same thing playing out. So now South Africa is destroying freedom of speech, clearly. And they're going to silence anybody from questioning what's going on. Twitter to remove harmful fake news about coronavirus. This is coming off The Guardian. Problem, reaction, solution. And they're talking about all these things. So here are some of the things. Denial of health authority recommendations with the intent to influence people into acting against recommended guidance, like encouraging people not to socially distance themselves. So if you're posting saying, hey, you know, go out, have a meal, hang out with your buddies. Description of treatments that are not immediately harmful but are known to be ineffective, even if made in jest. Such as coronavirus is not heat resistance, walking outside is enough to disinfect you, or use aromatherapy essential oils to prevent COVID-19. Descriptions of harmful treatments such as drinking bleach will kill COVID-19. Jordan Sather, aka Jude Law. Characters that pretend to be, or intelligence operations that put out purposeful misinformation to be used in this type of context. Specific unverified claims that incite people to action and cause widespread panic. The National Guard just announced that no more shipments of food will be arriving for 2 months. Run to the grocery store ASAP and buy everything. Claims that specific groups or nationalities are never susceptible or are more susceptible to COVID-19. False or misleading claims about on how to differentiate between COVID-19 and a different disease, and if that information attempts to definitively diagnose someone, such as if you have a wet cough, it's not coronavirus, but a dry cough is. You'll feel like you're drowning in snot if you have coronavirus. It's not the normal running nose. This is exactly 100% what I anticipated months back. I mean, we've been saying this all along, that they were going to use this to crack down, destroy freedom of speech. Here's Political from just a few hours ago. The coronavirus fake news pandemic sweeping WhatsApp. Russia goes after coronavirus in latest health misinformation push. Mother Jones, 9 hours ago, why coronavirus misinformation is out of control. There are gazillions of stories dealing with the misinformation, the disinformation, the conspiracies, and everything else, folks. Many of these things are put out by these intelligence operations in order to, of course, Hegelian dialectic, where it's like, well, we can't have bad information. We can't have people saying you got to drink bleach, so that they can show the sleeple, the sheeple, on CNN and Fox News, and they can say, this is why you can't have freedom of speech, because somebody's telling somebody to drink bleach. They're going to wipe out freedom of speech, folks. They're going to stick people in prison. The irony, too, is that they're letting prisoners out. We talked about this on the show that's shadow banned last night on Jeff C. Live with TMF, that they're opening the prisons. They're letting all the prisoners out because they're afraid, allegedly, of the spread of coronavirus. You think that's bad? They're stopping policing at the same time, where they're saying, you know, in Philadelphia, for example, which I showed in my video yesterday, they're saying, well, we're going to stop doing all routine sort of policing. We're not going to deal with, you know, people stealing things, or, you know, auto theft and all these different things. And they're releasing all the prisoners. It's very, very concerning. I have never, ever seen anything like this. and I'm very concerned about where this is all going.
I don't need another flu shot. I had a flu shot last year.
A swine flu epidemic may be coming.
Swine flu shot? Well, I don't know. I've been thinking about it.
It could make you very sick.
Swine flu? Man, I'm too fast for them to catch me.
You'll want to be protected.
I'm the healthiest 55-year-old you've ever seen. Hey, I play golf every weekend.
Get a shot of protection. The swine flu shot.
A little more adamant in my thoughts than my wife is, because I told Judy to take the shot. She wasn't going to take it, and she never had shots. And I'm mad with my government because they knew the facts, but they didn't release those facts because if they had released them, the people wouldn't have taken. And they can come out tomorrow and tell me there's going to be an epidemic, and they can drop off like flies to next to me. I will not take another shot that my government tells me to take.
Meantime, Judy Roberts and some 4,000 others like her are still waiting for their day in court.
Police are going to stop policing, basically. So look at this. Due to coronavirus crisis, Philadelphia police will no longer be making arrests for all narcotic offenses, theft from person, retail theft from auto, burglary, vandalism, bench warrants, stolen autos, economic crimes, such as passing bad checks, fraud, prostitution. And here's their statement that they put out, just saying they're not going to do any of this. They're basically not going to do police work. And at the same time, people are flooding the gun stores because it only makes sense, right? You're worried about your safety, your family. And if the police aren't doing their work...
Get a shot of protection. The swine flu shot.